Welcome to Royal Palace College online classes. So, in our first session of competitive, that is CET or NEET class, we have discussed about CET or NEET. We have discussed about some basic concepts of chemistry. Now, after that chapter, we are going to discuss some basic principles in organic chemistry. Okay, so this chapter has madam completed on online classes. Now we are going to start with CET or NEET. Okay, so let's start with the questions, sir. So before going to questions, today most of the questions we are framed on IPS in aim and hybridization. First, let me give you some basic idea of hybridization. See, what is hybridization? Intermixing of the atomic orbitals. Okay, intermixing of the atomic orbitals to produce equivalent energy, equivalent number of orbitals, hybrid orbitals is called as hybridization. For example, I will say, intermix with the px or py or pz, okay, px or py pz, or one p orbital, you can take like that also, one s orbital is mixed with one p orbital. Then if two atomic orbitals, I am writing AO, AO means atomic orbital. If two atomic orbitals, one s orbital, one p orbital, if they intermix together, you know that s is spherical, p is a double shape. Okay, so if two atomic orbitals mixes together, they will give two hybrid orbitals, and such type of hybrid orbitals are represented like this: one big lobe and one small lobe. Okay, like this: one big lobe, small lobe, one big lobe, small lobe. This type of hybridization is called sp hybridization. It is called as sp hybridization. That is, when one s atomic orbital mixes with one p atomic orbital, produces two hybrid orbitals. This is one hybrid orbital, this is another hybrid orbital. It is called sp hybridization. And in sp hybridization, the bond angle between the two hybrid orbitals is 180 degrees. Bond angle will be 180 degrees, and since they are in straight line, okay, so if any atom or a molecule is in sp hybridization, then its geometry is going to be linear. 180 degrees linear molecule. 180 degrees itself, you can understand that two lobes are oriented exactly opposite to each other, or like they are present in straight line. So the molecule will be linear with 180 degrees bond angle. Such type of hybridization is called sp hybridization. And the percentage of s and the percentage of p in sp hybridization is 50:50 or 1:1%. Simple ratio, 1:1. That is, here s orbital 50%, p orbital 50%. Okay, so that means 1 s orbital divided by totally 2 orbitals into 100. 1 by 2 into 100 means 50, like that. Similarly, 1 s orbital can intermix with 2 p
PR becomes, that is PXPY, assume like that, PXPY. So one S atomic orbital, okay, hybrid orbitals have radius HO, hybrid orbital. So one S atomic orbital mixes with two, okay, TW, two PR orbitals. So let us assume like this, I am drawing S is spherical. Okay, one PR orbital double shape, one more PR orbital in another double, X and Y, let us assume PX, PY. Okay, PX and PY in this way. So when such a type of intermixing takes place, when such type of hybridization takes place, here 1 plus 2, totally 3 atomic orbitals are mixed. So 3 hybrid orbitals will produce. That is, 3 hybrid orbitals are oriented in this way with larger lobes and smaller lobes inside them. Or we can also represent outside, no issue. So this type of representation, it looks like a triangular and all the lobes are present in one plane. So SP2 hybridization means one S orbital mixed with two P orbitals. It is written like this. SP2 hybridization. So in SP2 hybridization, the bond angle between the lobes or the hybrid orbitals is 120 degrees. Is 120 degrees and the shape is trigonal means triangular, planar shape or geometry. Okay, and what about the percentage of S and P? Percentage of S is 1/3 × 100. Okay, so it is 1/3%, 1/3 × 100%. 2 is PR orbitals is 2/3 × 100%. 2/3 × 100%. Okay, so that means here 100/3, if you do for example, so it will be around 33.33%. Okay, and this will be around 2/3 means 2/3 will be, or else you can say 100 minus 33 means this is 7 and this is 9, so 60. So 67.6%, you can take it 6/7 or 7/7%. Okay, so that is the percentage of P. Similarly, one S orbital can mix with 3 P orbitals. Okay, one S atomic orbital can mix with 3 P atomic orbitals. So assume this is PY, PX, PZ. Okay? So totally 3XYZ. That hybridization results in this type of shape. 3 lobes oriented down, 1 lobe is oriented upside with small lobes. This shape is called tetrahedral. Tetrahedral shape. Okay. Bond angle will be 109 degrees 28 minutes. 109 degrees 28 minutes. This hybridization is sp3, intermixing of one s orbital with 3 p orbitals. is sp3 hybridization. And percentage of s is 1 by 4, means 20%. 20% of s capital, remaining will be 80% of p capital. Okay? So, in most of the organic compounds, you find sp hybridization, carbon in sp2 hybridization, or carbon in sp3 hybridization. These are the three common hybridizations we will study in here. Next, we'll directly go into the questions now. So, in questions, first question. First question is, CH, this compound is given here, CH2, double bond CH, single bond C, triple bond M, here 1, here 2. Hybridization of C1 and C2 carbons is, now you remember, in any organic compound, if you want to find out the hybridization, if there are four sigma bonds, you should count the total number of sigma bonds around the carbon. If there are four sigma bonds around the carbon, hybridization is sp3. If there are three sigma bonds around the carbon, hybridization is sp2. If there are two sigma bonds only around the carbon, then it is sp hybridization. This is the shortcut to remember. Okay? It is a shortcut to remember. If any carbon having four sigma bonds around it, sp3 hybridization. If any carbon having only 3 sigma bonds around it, then it is sp2 hybridization. If any carbon having only 2 sigma bonds around it, then sp hybridization. So that we need to remember. Now, first carbon is having 1 sigma bond between carbon and nitrogen, and 2 sigma and 1 more sigma bond between first carbon and second carbon. So totally how many sigma bonds are there? On the first carbon. You should know that the remaining two bonds are pi bonds here. This is one pi bond, this is one pi bond. Don't count the pi bonds, only sigma bonds. So how many sigma bonds are formed by this carbon? Two. Two sigma bonds means what I said? It is sp hybridized. So first carbon is sp hybridized. Second carbon. Here, this hydrogen I am writing like this. So this carbon is having how many sigma bonds? First carbon, second carbon, one sigma bond. Second and third carbon, one sigma bond. This carbon and hydrogen, one sigma bond. So totally how many sigma bonds are there? Totally 3 sigma bonds are there. If 3 sigma bonds are there, what is the hybridization? It is sp2 hybridization. So what is the answer? C1 sp2. C2, sp2. So sp, sp2 should be the answer. Sp, sp2. Answer is C. Sp and sp2. Now, same type of question. Hybridization of carbon atoms in CC single bond of the compound. Now let us see what is the compound here. The compound is HC triple bond C single bond C H double bond CH2. This is the compound given to us. In this, they are asking hybridization of carbon atoms in CC single bond means these two carbons. CC single bond means these two. These two carbons, what is the hybridization state? Let us count the total number of sigma bonds, then you can easily say hybridization. Here 1 sigma, here 1 sigma. So totally this carbon is having 2 sigma bonds. 2 sigma bonds means what is the hybridization? Sp hybridization. Sp. Similarly, this carbon if you look, I write this H like this. So here 1 sigma, 2 sigma, 3 sigma. Okay? So this carbon having how many sigma? 3 sigma bonds. 3 sigma bonds means what is the hybridization?
Next.
Which of the following has maximum S character? Now just now I said you maximum S character. Here they have given SP3, SP2, S. SP, SP2 and SP3. Maximum S character. Here this S character is total orbitals 2, that means 1/2 into 100%. Here S character is only 1s, total orbitals 3, 1/3 into 100. Here S character is 1s, total orbitals are 4, so 1/4 into 100. So which is maximum S character here? Maximum S character is 1/2 into 100, 50%. This will be 32.83. This will be 20%. So what is the right option in this? The right option is C. Okay? So which of the following has maximum S character? SP hybridization. Okay? Then next question. The suffix for alcohols, aldehydes and ketones is, as you know, according to IPAC, alcohol should end with OL, aldehyde AL, ketone OME. So where is that option? OL, AL, OME. That means option C. That is alcohol, aldehyde, ketone. Next, IUPAC name of the compound. Okay, so one compound is given to us, CH3, CH, CH2, CH, OH, CH3 is the compound. And here they have written C2H5. Here they have written C2H5. C2H5 can be written as CH2CH3. C2H5 can be written as CH2CH3. Now, what is the name of this compound? First select the largest chain or parent chain. Then you can name the compound. If I say straight line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, only 5 carbons. If I take like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, means what should be the parent chain? Parent chain must be this chain because it covers maximum carbon atoms in this line. Okay, and numbering should be done from which manner? Numbering should be always in such a way that least sum is followed. See, here if I write numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, first position, fourth position, function scripts coming. Here if I count like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here 5. Okay, so 5 plus 3, 4 plus 1, which is the least number, 4 plus 1 is least number, that means numbering should be done in this way. And also, high priority should be given to the OH group. So this is correct number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is the numbering of the compound. So second position alcohol, fourth position methyl group is there. So what should be the name of the compound? Name of the compound must be 4-methyl. At fourth position, methyl, 4-methyl. Then what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Parent chain is hexane. So hexane. Where is the alcohol present? Second position. So hexane 2-all. So 4-methyl, hexane 2-all. Or 4-methyl, 2-hexanol should be the option. So we can see in these four options, this is the correct one. 4-methyl-hexane 2-all is the correct option. You can also write it as 4-methyl-2-hexanol. There is no problem. Next question. IUPAC name of the compound. IUPAC name of the compound. CH3, C double bond O. CH2, OH. Okay? This is the compound given to you. And in this now there are two functional groups. One is ketone another one is alcohol. So which should be given a highest priority? Ketone should be given highest priority. Means numbering in this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. If alcohol, if OH is present as a substituent functional group, not main functional group, because main functional group is ketone, then it should be given hydroxy. Prefix is hydroxy. Suffix will be OL, alcohol. But if this is not the main functional group, then it should be given prefix. What is prefix? Hydroxy. Suffix is OL. And which position it is present? Fourth position. The name of the compound is 4-hydroxy. 4-hydroxy. Okay. Second position, ketone is there. What is the parent chain? Butyl. Okay. Butyl 2-ohm should be the butyl 2-ohm should be the compound. Or 4-hydroxy 2-butanone. 4-hydroxy 2-butanone can be the option. So butyl 2-ohm, or you can write like this also. 4-hydroxy 2-butanone. This is also correct. So what is that? 4-hydroxy 2-butanone. Option C. Option is C. Next, the first organic compound synthesized in the lab was, okay, so that you will read in the textbook, NCERT textbook, as urea. Okay, urea is the first organic compound synthesized by Wohler, okay, in the lab. Next, by heating ammonium cyanide, Wohler synthesized urea, first time in the organic compound in the lab. Next, IUPAC name of CH3 taken thrice COH is, this is like condensed formula they have given. First we will write an elaborated formula to name the compound. And CH3 taken how many times? 3 times. So first I am writing this carbon. This carbon is like this. On this carbon OH is attached. OH is attached. And along with OH, 3 CH3s are attached. 3 methyl groups. Means 1 methyl group I am writing above, 1 methyl group below, 1 methyl group side opposite to OH. So CH3. Now you should select first longest parent chain. Longest parent chain, either you select like this or like this or like this. Anyhow, three carbons can be the longest. So let me select like this, it is easy for you to give the number. And one more thing is, you can number from upside to downside or down to up. Why? Because however it is, the carbon should be in the second position now. If I number it from top to bottom or bottom to top, the number should be in between only 2. So numbering 1, 2, 3. So what is the additional group? Methyl. What is main group? Alcohol. So suffix must be OL. And here methyl group should be written first. So compound name should be 2-methyl. This is 3-carbon compound. Okay, 3-carbon compound means propane. And where is the alcohol on second position? 2-ol. Propane, 2-ol. Or else 2-methyl, 2-propanol also you can write. 2-methyl, 2-propanol. 2-propanol also accepted. Okay? So there is the 2-methyl-2-propanol. Option is D. Option D. Next question is, structure of neopentane is now, as you know, neo means what? Neo is the word given for quaternary carbon. Neo is the word given for quaternary carbon. Quaternary carbon means what? The carbon that is attached to four more carbons. The carbon attached to four carbons is called quaternary carbon. As you know, if carbon is attached to only one carbon, it is primary carbon. If carbon is attached to two carbons, then secondary carbon. If carbon is attached to three carbons, it is tertiary carbon. And if carbon is attached to all sides, all four bonds with carbon only, then it is quaternary carbon. Quaternary carbon commonly called neocarbon. Neocarbon. So what they are asking is, structure of neopentane is, neo means quaternary carbon should be there. Where it is? Here and here. But they are asking neopentane. Pentane means how many carbons must be present? Only 5. Here you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 carbons. Here you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only 5 carbons. So what is the correct structure? Neopentane is this structure. B. So, one carbon surrounded by 4 methyl groups is called as neopentane. This is called as neopentane. 5 carbons with the central carbon attached with 4 methyl groups. This is neopentane. Okay? Thank you for now. We continue this one.